our Sabertooth CPU module is a PCIe 104 embedded computer with a 6-core Xeon processor, up to 32 gigs of ECC RAM, and 128 gig onboard NVMe SSD. In addition, it includes dual gigabit Ethernet ports and comes in a passively cooled, heat pipe cooled variation, so that users can actually integrate it into completely fanless designs. Also, by using the BI16 port, customers can expand, add GPUs, Ethernet modules, even low-speed RS-232, those kinds of add-ons to the stack as well. And we also just announced this guy, which is our new 10 gig Ethernet. It's dual 10 gigabit Ethernet module. Two RJ45 10 gigabit ports, so no need for SFP sockets or SFP modules. This plugs into that same BI16 connector and then provides you with the two 10 gigabit Ethernet ports. Comes in both an air-cooled version as well as a version that's integrated into the Sabertooth module using those same integrated heat pipes up to the passive cooling plate, and in a dense, very compact solution for customers that can be integrated. Minus 40 to plus 85, mil 202G shock and vibe, and backed by all of Versalogic's warranty and long-term availability support. PC 104 in 2023 is kind of an interesting topic. People seem to think it's an older standard, but we do find that a lot of our customers are still integrating and designing in even original PC 104 Plus designs. So folks that need lower speed buses, lower power consumption levels, are still picking ISA and PCI-based PC 104 Plus boards for lower power applications where they don't need really high performance CPUs, but that they need something a little bit better than a microcontroller, for example. We're still seeing a really robust ecosystem of add-on boards, both from ourselves, of course, but also from others in the industry. But we do see also that we're releasing, and our competitors and others in the ecosystem are releasing more and more with the PCIe 104 or the PCIe 104 Express options. So those are usually used for when you've got to get to a situation like a high-speed BI16, BI8, PCIe connection for GPUs, Ethernet modules, or for motion capture, that kind of thing. But we are seeing still a pretty good mix. Most of our new designs on the higher end are opting for those higher speed interconnects, like things that come like on our board, like the Sabertooth. All of our boards, even our stacking PC 104 stuff, we are starting to add mini PCIe sockets and M.2 sockets in the near future, because there's what we kind of call that last mile I.O., where folks can't quite get everything they need in the stack. They need that one last Ethernet port or another couple of serial ports, and being able to add those on with very low impact to the stack size has been really beneficial to our customers. In addition, we've got things like 5G on the horizon with M.2 sockets coming in the next year, and we're going to need to be able to accommodate those for our customers moving forward. Speaking of PC 104 boards, starting with the low end that we have, this is our Tomcat board. This is going to be a headless design, no video output. Going to be for those really low end applications, very low power draw, under 5 watts kind of stuff. Followed by the Fox, which is just a little bit more potent in that it does have video output, a little bit more RAM. Both of these are PC 104 Plus boards using the traditional connectors. And then we have kind of an interesting one with this heatsink on it here, which is our Sandcat. This is a scaled back, cost optimized version of one of our Atom boards. So it's going to have just a really basic I.O., kind of that minimal level to get folks started. It does have a mini PCIe socket on it, though, so folks can add, as well as being able to stack, again, with the traditional PCI 104 Plus bus. Baycat and the Bengal are close relatives. They're both going to be Atom processors with onboard memory. And then one is a PC 104 Plus, and the other one is actually a one-bank PCIe 104 board. And then we move over into our Lion and our Liger, which are cousins. This is a PCI 104 Intel Core i7 board. And then this is the PC 104 Plus version of the same board by adding a mezzanine connector. We talked earlier about mini PCIe modules, and Versalogic has a pretty wide range of them, from everything from our 8-port RS-232 boards all the way up to our brand new 2.5 gigabit dual Ethernet with TSN support. GPS, analog, digital I.O., and as well as GPS or GPS modules. We even have a CAN bus card for those customers that are operating in a space where that CAN bus is important. And we even have a FireWire card for those customers who are still integrating older camera systems or want to retrofit a system with a new SBC and want to have that connectivity to the old camera.